Wotja can be used to create generative music with a wide range of sounds and characteristics. It doesn't all have to be ambient, but we don't set out to do that in this tutorial. Before we start, I'd like to give a quick overview of the three main apps we have for 2019. The device home screen shows three Wotja app icons: Wotja, Wotja Pro 19, and Wotja Go 19. The Wotja icon on the left is that of the free version of the generative music system Wotja V19. It can be used as both a creator and player and operates by default with a free mode feature set. It will always get updates to the latest version. In the iOS and macOS versions, it can be unlocked to give it a pro or unlocked feature set, their equivalent. In other versions, such as Windows and Android, it is presently locked in free mode. The paid-for Pro version in 2019 is called Wotja Pro 19, and it can be used as both a creator and a player. This operates with an unlocked or Pro feature set again, and gets updates in 2019 only. The paid-for Wotja Go 19 app is a player app, meaning it has no capabilities for mix editing. It has a subset of the capabilities of the Pro version and is perfect, however, for those who just want to play. It is also our app for iOS and Android in 2019 that includes a TV app. As a quick heads up, in 2020, we will look to further rationalize the Wotja product range and naming. Anyhow, for our tutorials, we will use an app with the unlocked or pro feature set. We could use either the free version with an active unlocked or pro subscription, or the paid for version, Wotja Pro 19. We will use the latter, and for this tutorial, it will operate as a fresh install. On the load screen, some versions will show the version number, so let's load Wotja Pro 19. The first thing you'll see on launch, and only for versions that support iCloud, is an iCloud-related pop-up. For a number of reasons outlined on our website, we recommend using iCloud if you have it. I'll show separately on this screen two settings that you can change afterwards if you want, and you will need to have toggled on an iCloud Drive and then iCloud Drive toggle for the relevant Wotja app and also the Use iCloud toggle for the Wotja app. It's a bit complicated and we deal with it in our user guide. Okay, let's select the iCloud setting. What we see here is the Documents screen for a fresh install. Top left is a Settings button. Top right is an action button, and then we have three segments at the top: flow, user, built-in. It will open by default after a fresh install in the user segment, and we have a flow button and an add new button. In the built-in segment, we have two albums currently included, which are albums that are built-in. In the flow, we have a number of different schemes that can be used to create a continuous flow of mixes that are generated automatically. So we're going to concentrate on the user screen for the time being, and we are now going to go into the action button, and you'll see we have refresh and sort order. Refresh allows you to refresh the icons in the document screen, and it can come in handy. Sort order allows you to choose the order that you want your icons to be displayed, and that's also quite handy, but as we have no icons at the moment, we don't need that. The next thing is the settings button. The settings screen contains two segments, general and randomization. In this screen, the general screen, we first of all have a sleep timer. If you set this, then when you are in an album or in flow mode, the app will stop playing when it reaches that time. We will turn that off for now. We have a user interface scheme, which is either light or dark, so I'm going to put it back to light. We have two important options here: autoplay on document open. This is primarily for use with mixes, but it will work in albums, and it means basically play when you open it. And the important one for now is highlight touch click events to help with video creation. Once we've got that, when we tap on something, you'll be able to see it. Below that, we have audio output. An important one here is ISE for sounds and effects. This one here. If you turn it off, then Wotja will not generate any sound. You'll have to use an external MIDI unit to generate sound, a MIDI synth. So we're going to leave it on so we can hear it. We have audio settings, which are, these are the defaults. You can change if you need to. MIDI output is where you would select your output devices if you wish to use MIDI output. You have virtual MIDI, MIDI clock, and other MIDI settings. We detail all this in the user guide. Input devices, it's a similar thing, and you would use this if you wish to drive Wotja via MIDI input. Again, that's a separate thing, with MIDI transport control and external clock sync. The final section is recording, and this is an override for when you create mixed down recordings. If you wish to make very long ones, you can use this setting to override what is in the mixed down recordings screen. In the randomization segment, we have at the top a button which allows you to select a randomization scheme. These are used when creating mixes in flow mode and also when creating albums, and they follow various settings that we set below here. I won't go into this at the moment because it's very detailed, but there are all kinds of things you can set up. We might make that a separate tutorial. Let's go back to the document screen now. So we will start with the built-in albums. If we just press one or tap it, it will open into an album player and you will hear it playing. To select another mix, either tap on it here like that, and then that will start playing. To view it full screen, tap on the thumbnail. You will notice that a little band appears at the top. That's so you can see what's happening once it's playing. If you tap the screen again, it will take you back to the playlist or album player view. That's probably all we need to show at this moment in time, except if you tap the icon up here, the timer, this is where you can set the sleep timer if you wish. So we'll go back here. These albums are very beautiful to listen to, and you can play them in shuffle mode or playlist mode. So we'll come back out of this. You'll notice there's a settings button in this screen at the top here, and we have a forward and back icons as well as stop. And if we press stop and then play, it'll play it again. So we're going to go back out of that into the document screen. If we now tap on the flow mode, this is where you can choose one of a number of different randomization schemes to create mixes for you. If we now tap on the default button, like so, this will create an automatically generated mix, and we call this flow mode because it just creates a sequence of mixes that are freshly created. We could set the sleep timer here by tapping on the timer button and then setting it like this, but we won't do that for now. We'll come back. If we exit flow mode, then we can choose another scheme. Let's choose ambient mixes box 1, and it will create another flow mode based on the randomization scheme selected for it. So if we go into settings and then randomization, we can see that for the ambient mixes box scheme, we could select or change the templates. You can change a scheme and override a scheme and create a new scheme. For example, perhaps there are some synth presets selected in there, which means when a flow mode is created, it will randomly select from this list of FX presets at the mix level. We can change things like the icon palette. There's different settings that you can have for that. They're all different colors. The pattern can be geometric or blobs. And the icon or the screen can display cut-up text, text to music, or none. We have other settings such as the number of mixes that are created when you create an automatic album, which we'll do in a second, how long the mix is played for, this is a duration, and the max duration, duration range and max, what the tempo is, and the range of the tempos, and how long it takes for the mix to ramp up and ramp down. There are other settings for like how many text to music templates are used. It's a bit more complicated, and so we won't go into that now. So let's go back and let's come out of this. Next, we're going to go to the user segment, and we're going to go from here. You'll notice there's a flow button. If we do select this flow button here, it will open up the default setting, but we can change the scheme by just selecting from here. So actually, we'll see it set on ambient mixes 1. We could select bell melodies, and next time it creates in flow, it would use that. So we're going to come out here. If we tap on the Add New button, you will see Album Automatic, Mix Manual, Mix from Clipboard, Cut Up Text and Playlist. Each of these menu items does something different. What we'll do first of all is we will tap the Album Automatic menu item. This will create an album of mixes that have been generated automatically. So if we tap that, we'll see it's created an album called Marvelously Guess. We tap on that to open it. We can see there's a number of items in this album that have been created, and we can just play the album as we wish to. In the album, if you tap on the right button, there's something, a menu which allows you to change what are called mix overrides, so how quickly the mix will ramp up, how long it will play for its range and ramp down. So if we change the duration to say, I don't know, 4 minute 47, then we'll now see it says 4 minute 47. If we come back out of here, do we want to save and continue or save and close? Let's save and close. We've saved that change to the album. The next thing we will do is we will tap Add New again, and we will create a mix automatic. What this does is create an automatic mix that we can then edit. So if we tap on that mix, once it's been created, we will see we have a mix here. I'll just stop that for 1 second. So on this screen, we have a number of cells on the left. If you tap on one, you can change the template in it. You can tap on that one to select it, and then you'll see what the network is in this center screen here. If we tap in an empty cell, we can tap on a template to browse a template, to select a template to add to it. That tapping on it there will preview it. Tap again to stop the preview. Tap on it to preview. So let's say we loaded that to the mix screen. If we tap this top right toolbar button, we can select multi-column, single column, or single cell. In multi-column, you will see that we have a number of different cells that we can see, and each cell in each track is a cell that can be used in the mix. If we go to single cell, then the cell that has been selected on the left-hand side will show on this screen. This is what is equivalent to noticle mode, where a noticle would allow you to edit, in effect, a piece of music. This is one generative piece of music. So we're going to go back to showing single column here. Now, in the top toolbar, we have various different screens. This one shows you the text to music text that would be used in a text to music voice. We won't do that at the moment. The next one is the track or voice mixer. So in this particular cell, if we tap that button again, we can select the voice mixer, and that will allow you to, for the content in this particular cell, will allow you to change the individual volumes within the cell. The tools setting, view here shows you various things related to the content in that particular cell. And you can see there's the rules that are being used by this cell, or the content in this cell, whether it's harmony or scale or next note. You could add scripting if you wished to for the cell here, and so forth. We won't go into too much detail at the moment because we'll try to cover those things in another tutorial. So let's go back out of here. Do we want to save the changes? I guess we'll discard these changes. The next thing is to add new and create a mix manual. Basically, this creates an empty mix called Untitled. If we open the mix, you'll see that there's nothing in it. So we would need to add something to this mix to get started. So say we had that one. Okay. So we'll come back out of this. Discard that one. The next one we have is mix from Clipboard. We don't have a mix that we've exported to the Clipboard, so there wouldn't be anything that we'd create from that. But if you do export a mix to the Clipboard, you can then import from here or create a new mix from here. The next one's cut up text. What this does is create a file with no mix content in it, so it's empty, but it's got cut up in it, so cut up text, because one of the things Wotja can do is create basically cut up. So if we tap the bottom right randomize button, it will generate different text. We can lock a word by tapping on it, and if we randomize again, it locks those words but randomizes other things. We can also tap on a word, say fuchsia, and change it to the word options that are given at the bottom. If you tap on the screen anywhere, it'll give you different word options, so we could tap on that and have paper. There's a lot to this different side of Wotja in the cut up text side of things. We won't go into that now, that's a whole separate tutorial. So we're going to discard that too. And then the final one we have is a playlist. So if we create a playlist, basically this allows you to add other content to it and then to create an album from that. So if we tap the top left button, browse mixes, we can either add saved files, which is one of the ones we've just done, like Ineffable Wotja, we can add that. Or you can add templates. So if we had a template we particularly liked, soft pads, for example, we could add that. Now we now have a simple playlist. We can change to a random icon used for the album icon. And if we go back and if we save this and close it, what you'll see, that's got that random icon associated with it now. In the playlist, if you open it, you can export that to a Wotja Box file. If we press OK, we've now created a new album, which is, if you see from the bottom right-hand corner, there's a box icon on that. That's now a Wotja Box file, which contains everything it needs to play that particular album. And it's similar to the one on the far right, Marvelously Guess. Okay, that's a very simple overview of how to get into Wotja and from the documents screen.